Assalamu alaikum everyone, this is Dr. Unab Kaisar back with you with another video in which I try to share my experiences. And before starting anything, I would like to say belated happy Eid to everyone, and I hope you had a great Eid, and may Allah accept our prayers and sacrifices. In the modern teaching world, we have been blessed in some way with so many resources that are available to us in order to make us a better teacher. There are courses like Train the Trainers, Mastering the Art of Teaching, and so on and so forth. First of all, a little clarification: when I say trainers, they call us trainers, but we are not, I do not agree with this title. With a fixed curriculum and specific objectives to follow, you are just a teacher, okay? But that is another topic which we will discuss in some upcoming video. But in any case, we have these resources. If you are involved with teaching, your organization must be arranging these types of courses and workshops and seminars which help you to become a better teacher. Okay, how you can improve your body language, how you can improve your delivery of the lecture, which resources you can use, and with online teaching, which platforms are available to you, how to use them efficiently, and so on and so forth. And all these things are good. They are excellent, and even if your organization is not arranging such items for you, you should try to strive for them yourself. But while you are doing it, okay, as human beings, we all have deficiencies, okay, and no matter how much you try, at the end, you will always have some weaknesses and deficiencies. So today I am going to talk about how these deficiencies and weaknesses can and do become your strength as a teacher. Let me share you some experiences. In my undergraduate, when I was doing engineering, we were required to go for training in the industry in our third year. And we went to Civil Aviation Authority at the Jinnah International Airport at Karachi. So they usually assign a supervisor to the students who guides them, who lets them, you know, experience different things and so on and so forth. Our supervisor, he was the terminal manager from Civil Aviation Authority. He used to handle civil works and so on. And he assigned for a small tour. He assigned us to another guy, okay, and obviously that guy did not have a higher degree, okay. So his accent and the things were not so much developed, okay. His speech was not so much developed. Obviously they are working in the field, though they don't need these things as much as we do. So there was one incident where he had to say that this particular space is used by Air Blue airplanes. Okay, so instead of saying Air Blue, he said Air Balu. Okay, and it was very difficult for us. We were three of us were there, and it was very difficult for us to control our laughter. Okay, there was another incident where we went for sort of a training for elections. Okay, I don't remember the year, maybe 2008. Okay, or yeah, I think 2008. So in 2008, we were required to do election duty, as many teachers in Pakistan have to go through it when the election comes. And we went through a workshop, and in that workshop, the person who was giving the talk, he had to say voter, and he said water. Okay, and he said it repeatedly. Okay, so we laughed at him, obviously. Okay. There was another incident, there was another teacher, he was a teacher, okay. These guys were not, permanent teacher. But there was a teacher at our college level, and he used to teach us Pakistan studies. And during his lecture, he would ask something, and he would ask someone to stand up, and he would ask a question. And usually his question was, "What is OIC?" That was usually the question. And when you said Organization of Islamic Cooperation, he would, you know, react like this. "What did you say?" So, you know, he used to put his finger on the ear, and he used to, you know, come forward and so on. Okay. Now, I still remember all these things. There have been so many years. So many years have gone by, I still remember these things. These things are not, you can see, these are not the ideal things which you should do, using wrong accent and, putting your finger on the ear and so on and so forth. They are not the ideal things which they will teach you at the in these in a training courses and so on. But the point is, I remember these things. I remember what they said when they were doing this. Okay, so the point is, when you are showing a deficiency in the class, when you are showing a weakness in the class, obviously all of us have some weaknesses, deficiencies. This registers in the mind of the student. Okay, your weakness registers in the mind of the student, and he remembers what you are saying at that time. Okay, we had teachers who were very fat, we had teachers who were very short, okay, and so on and so forth. We had teachers who used to speak English in some funny accent. We remember them, we remember their words, we remember what they said at what time and so on and so forth. Okay, when they were joking in the class, we remember what, in which topic they were joking. Okay, and it happens to me a lot. Okay, I am a non-native English speaker. Okay, so I have problem with accent, and I have problem with, you know, pronouncing some words. Okay, and I used to stammer, I used to stutter. Okay, I still do. If you have seen my lectures, previous lectures, you would feel that there are some words on which I stutter and stammer. Okay, but I have felt during the years when I'm stuttering and stammering, I can use these words at which I'm stuttering and stammering to emphasize on them, because I know they will register in the mind of the listener. Definitely, most sure, 99.9% you are sure that in the whole lecture, if there were two words on which you stuttered, they will be in the mind of the listener, for sure. Okay. So my point is, if you have a deficiency, if you feel your personality is not good enough, you are bold, not bold, how do you pronounce it? See, okay, so you are a bald guy, or you are fat, you are short, okay? And I've seen many motivational speakers, especially from India, Pakistan, these countries who are non-native, and they are delivering some good content, okay? But their accent is not, you know, as perfect as it could be. But still, they are very effective. In fact, they are more effective than teachers who speakers who have perfect accent, okay? Because when they are speaking, everything is not just flowing through, okay? It's like up and down, okay? So these ups and downs, they register in your mind. Whenever you see something unique, it registers in your mind, okay? And this is what they will teach you in the training courses as well. Use the variation in your voice, use the hands, use the body language, use your eyes, and so on and so forth. Why? So that these things which you are using, they are basically etching your words into the mind of the listeners. Okay, and this is something which you develop. Okay, you try to develop, you train on these things and so on. But even the things which are coming naturally to you, which you consider as your deficiency, I'm not looking good, I'm not speaking well enough, even these things are an advantage to you. Someone who is perfectly neat and clean, and he's speaking in a very good with a very good vocabulary, and everything is so perfect about him. Sometimes they just go over your head. Okay, you lose them during their speech. You lose them. Okay, because everything is so, you know, up to your expected. Okay, and so on. But when someone comes who is very fat, by looking at him, he catches your eyes. Okay, he catches your attention. Fat, short, tall. Okay, I had a teacher who used to stand in a funny way. Okay, and when he was standing in that way, I remember what he was saying, because he caught my attention. Okay, whether he was doing it intentionally or unintentionally, it doesn't matter. Okay, so if you feel you are not walking correct, you have some problem in you, don't get discouraged. Okay, continue your teaching, do your best, even with these things. Be confident. These things are helping you. Believe me, these things are helping you. For sure. Okay. So if you have something which you consider as your deficiency and you are a teacher, you try to improve as much as possible. But whatever is left with you, that is an advantage. Don't get ashamed with your accent, because of your personality. Okay, just focus on the content which you are delivering. Okay, and these things will help you. Okay, because again, I will go back to the saying of the Prophet ﷺ, that innama al-amalu binniyat, the results of your deeds depends upon your intention. Okay, intentions. So your intention is to do good. Okay, your intention is to deliver the content in an effective way. Your intention is to deliver the information. You are trying to do your job efficiently and with dedication and commitment. So Allah will make these things advantageous for you. Okay, that is the part of tawakkul. That is the part of faith and belief. That if I am doing my job properly, then Allah's help will come. Even though on surface I don't look perfect. Even though on surface I am doing something which doesn't look perfect. But I am using whatever I have. Okay. So this is where your faith and belief comes into play, and it is tested. And this is where you need to have it. Okay. But again, as I am saying, try to improve as much as possible. Okay, learn from others, learn from your peers, learn from colleagues, and from whichever resource you can. But in the end, after doing your best, don't get discouraged. Don't be ashamed of yourself. Okay, feel confident. If you have given your best, feel confident. Okay, especially because of the superficial things. Okay, your accent, your personality, and these things. Okay, if you are feeling ashamed, it will get worse. If you are feeling ashamed, it will get worse. Okay, if you are feeling confident, make a joke out of it yourself. You know, you are fat whenever something comes in that regard. I'm not saying that you make the class into a laughing club, but whenever something related to that comes, you go through it smoothly. It is what it is. Okay, you cannot change it. Be confident. Okay, do your best, and these things will be to your advantage in the end. Okay, that's the beauty of teaching, and that's the beauty of academics. Unusual things get your attention, catch the attention of the listeners, and they get they get what you want. They catch what you want. Okay, so I hope this was useful, and I pray that Allah gives us the strength to do our job properly and efficiently. Assalamu alaikum.